In 19th century India, education of women was a widely unknown concept. There were a number of reasons why women were deprived of the fruit of knowledge. Child marriage was prevalent in the society, and girls at a very young age were victims of this tradition. It was blindly believed that if a girl was taught to read and write, it would lead to an untimely death of her husband. Despite such beliefs, daring young women went on to shatter these social obstacles. This is the story of Rukhmabai. Let us find out how Rukhmabai became one of the first female practicing doctor in India and her contribution to the enactment of the Age of Consent Act in 1891. Rukhmabai was born in a Marathi family in 1864. At an early age, Rukhmabai's father passed away, and her mother, who was only 17, was remarried to Dr. Sakharam Arjun, who was a doctor and a professor. At the tender age of 11, Rukhmabai was married to Dadaji Bhikaji, who was 19 years old. Rukhmabai's stepfather made the decision of the married couple not living together due to her tender age. During the years the couple lived apart, Rukhmabai continued her education at home. Because of her father's association with religious and social reformers, she also came in contact with prominent names like Vishnu Shastri Pandit, a strong supporter of women's causes in Western India at that time, along with European men and women exposing her to ideas of liberty and consent. All these years, Dadaji never worried about her wife. He only came in touch with her when he was drowning in immense debt. He was perhaps interested in the money she had inherited after her mother's passing. She refused to go and continue to live with her stepfather and pursue her education, going against the norms of the society. Dadaji moved court, seeking it to order his wife to live with him. In 1885, after 12 years of marriage, Dadaji sought restitution of conjugal rights, where the hearing and judgment was presided by Justice Robert Hill Pinhey. Rukhmabai refused to move in with her husband, stating that a woman cannot be compelled to stay in a wedlock when she is not interested. British law was meant to be applied in the case of consenting adults. Hence, his judgment on the case stated that Rukhmabai had been wed as an innocent child, had no say in the matter, and now couldn't be forced. The case was brought up again in 1886 and drew attention of different parts of the society. Rukhmabai was the first Hindu woman to have challenged the notions of marriage, not accepting it just as a sacred practice, but recognizing the need of the bride's consent. The society did not accept her notion, with some Hindus stating that the law did not respect the Hindu rituals and customs. This case caught attention of people in both India and England. The verdict was given in favor of Dadaji. In March 1887, Rukhmabai was given the choice of either moving in with her husband or spending 6 months in jail. She chose to spend 6 months in jail. Rukhmabai then wrote to Queen Victoria seeking help. She wrote that man before the age of 20 and girls before the age of 15 should not be considered legal in the eyes of law. The Queen overruled the court's verdict and dissolved the marriage. In July 1888, Dadaji accepted monetary compensation of 2,000 rupees to dissolve the marriage. The ripples that the case created led to the influence on the passage of the Age of Consent Act 1891, which made child marriages illegal across the British Empire. Rukhmabai continued her education and went on to becoming a widely esteemed feminist and medical practitioner for the rest of her life. Despite the strong constraints of the society, she fought for her liberty and consent by standing against the institution of child marriage. She is a true inspiration.